Good morning. This is the Canadian Trilogy by Sandro Ermindo Fermo.
Parts 1, 2, and 3, I think, for this one.
We're going to start off today by reading something real quickly.
Hello, here I am.
The molecular disposition carries a lot of weight as we search for the dismissive component that leads us towards that greater height that the elastic movement just came and went in a pensive brain process, and the silhouette returned nonetheless with the beloved interior. We are a step nearer to an ecstatic abode that is always clearer. So, that was part one.
Here's the scene. Controversial scene. I was referring to. And I'm going to read now. I stole it out. Here's all. I'm still here. You want to see it? Try it again. There you go.
I watched sea beams glitter in the balcony of 10 hours a day. All those moments will be lost in time, like tears.
Plagiarism? Fuck. It's dangerous. This is where I like to pass through all
cinnamon salsa. I guess you're through, huh?
He's through. Not me. This is a Canucks lament. Fraternal escapade is heading towards the cool shade, the help that helps to soothe or toil while playing a major role, even crisply loving the chilly North Pole, that causes a brisk fall and creates an environmental stall with rigid winds and a cold shock that comfortably hides the hot from winter, and only then, much later, some poor cat goes underground for searching for some gloves in the lost and found. For now, a wild boar lies beside some enchanted so-called whore that is squirrelishly storing his stuff and saving his money, mixing up beloved late poured honey. But the true wisdom lies within a child's kingdom of imagination, without a cultural indignation, to certify why some people care about those who pour some dark beacon that stare, while progressive rock and power. Little boy Peep got the flower and nicely dismissed his permissive state to gain some political weight and indulge himself and oneself in a torrid statement of only leftist government that is consistency with our DNA's frequency. For the monster mash gave in to such a cherished stash, beguiling and fooling those who, upon his ambivalence and drooling, thought that it was just a formidable insight that he subdued with his flight, with silly reckonings of self-destruction, allowing form to function, with the solidity of his grandeur, and like listening to his forefathers that were not vindictive, but carelessly constrained by what was very bewitchedly by bewitched reciprocality that he ever so righteously did disdain. Not enslaved by imagery or two-bit cheap entertaining dredgers, funked out and thrust about with a willingly unbastardized shout, that dethroned and disowned notoriety with brutal misgivings of frivolity, stoned with truth, not afraid of some monstrous sleuth, cursing his lament that was supposedly and never so accordingly some time well spent. But resolve and sandor has earned his pay by the plow, by hauling brick mortar and blocks, muscling himself up like a poor enslaved proletariat pup that astonishes those who have made it, that has made his pride castrate the inevitable rising tide, but shall pursue economical, peaceful ways, being it all for Indian Joe and all those so-called fucking frightening strays. And a part one. Or should I continue? I'll continue. Italian Canadian infantryman, the cure to the ailment, and sometimes economical perturbance, are forward marching derailments that inhibit those incitingly shattered conflicts without the foolhardy so-called righteous derelicts that have cast a disgusting spell from their earthbound hell and reeked of some used, impotent condom that castrates the need of self-negating wisdom. But the true measure of boring their ideological treasure is by whipping their powdered butts with something called Canadian guts, that are kinder,
that a kind that's seemingly undermined, for God has decreed that they, that hate towards their self-loving, they towards their self-loving, not be freed. But now there lurks a Muslim who is enchantingly handsome towards those who cannot perceive their propagated woes. And in order to battle diseased cattle, one must clean the stable, and our inner torment is able. If you are worth it, and can possibly discourage your false prophets, then you can come along for the ride. And then, my military brethren, we'll tan your fucking eyes with the disgust of a mythological must to no longer pierce his side from those who, from any righteous perspective, do negate the tongue or hide.
Okay? So, bear with me. Google time. Bear with me. This is the song I chose this morning. And Then I'll Never Be by Boston. Then I'll Never Be. And I'll Never Be. This is a mobster, mafioso, a derelict or a bum. And if I am a bum, it's because they turned me into one. God knows the psychiatric facility I was working for, and so like earthbound ways, didn't give me a job. But if they want to, it's too late now, because as you see, this is Italy. So big this life. Reservation.
Hear the word CIA in between the words.
Thank you.
background, you notice like a sort of like a queenly like backdrop, you know, for like for the monarchy. Like they're nice people and everything. They really dig words. But if you get Mr. If you say your comments, which I'm no longer, you know, but you shouldn't laugh about that too much. Because, you know, the enemy of the monarchy are people who believe in proletariat values and who don't like people who have too much money. See, for the Queen, everything is a pantomime. Everything is a joke. Everything is a fable. Like the queenly killer and kingly guys, or the wretched, the Shylock type of individual who we're supposed to hate through some godless decree of bullshit routines that I underwent from my father's family, which is like can be seen in my earlier videos. But as here goes, before this thing fades out, this is where I am now. What you got? Hold on here. Okay, so reservation and acknowledgement out of an inedible folly. That's not going to happen. Don't worry. It's permissive subconsciousness. Wait a minute, it did. That seeks for journalistic justice and democratic steadfast security that succumbs towards realistic purity. Maybe it's a takeoff from All the President's Men. For the awakening of foresight shall prove our cherished might, and great glasses will consecrate who the real boss is, the populace and its perturbment of seeking clarification of that willing consolation that is